I see a purple shirt on the uniform. Her feature on the traveling like very loyal. Yeah, we're all in the same row. Thank you.
Well, they need to get those.
Thank you.
Ashamed of what this about you turn your will upon. And so open your eyes, keeping them open. And so relentless awareness in the face of a billion layered instructions that all the way have been given. Stare at them, they're easy to believe. So many bright flashing empty objects, and you can get your attention to hers. But the marvelous and terrifying thing is the only one in charge where that attention goes is you. Think about that. You're all being happy to be the world of your creation. Your generation officially matters the most of all the generations here. That's why all the older folks in here are different side. We're all jealous that you're being handed the keys to the car, and we're going to move to the next. I've been having more excited this year than kids. But to assuage some of the fears, let me address the parents, grandparents, step-parents, aunts, uncles, siblings, well-wishers, ill-wishers, and people just wandering down the street. When you hear bad news about this generation, when you expect the world to fall apart once you're gone, when you want to believe the worst, I ask you to stop and look closer. Look past slowly in the face of comfort. Look past genders you don't recognize. Look past music that is objectively horrible. Look past the omnipresent phones and listen. Listen to the furious hearts of a generation that is growing under an onslaught of social pressure and demoralizing news that you hear they have. Look closely and see a lot to love, a lot to give you hope. It's the empathy and the grand spirit, the spirit of acceptance, open-mindedness, and self-awareness that our generation is aware of. But enough about you. Back to the start of the show. Class of 2023, you made it through. Made it to the top of the mountain. Here you are. It's kind of an anticlimactic right now. So it's the top of any mountain where the achievement of any dream. This isn't where they hide the fun. The process of making it through is where all the fun is. If you don't spend some time looking around and appreciating making it through, then you're just living for the next immense life-changing anticlimactic time, the next milestone. That's that. That's how you miss everything cool and die in it. Don't do that. So let's look at this moment for a second. You are here. You might be bored, more enthralled, tired of wide awake, dancing for the big amazing incident or anxious for the next catastrophe. But you are here, surrounded by these people, wearing these robes, and soon even in this building, as full of time and possibilities as it'll ever be, ready to go find what you're supposed to do. But all you're supposed to do is pay attention. Keep your eyes open for everything. Learn to love every part of the search. Every moment that fills your heart is a brand, every loss that follows before. There is no achievement, no failure in life. No grades, no tests. Just moments that ask for your attention, and the will of everyone. The only failure in life is to walk through. The only achievement is to make you painfully aware. So when you get out of here, look around. Every blade of grass, every neon leaf is fresh. The sky is painfully bright. And it all faces to the extent that you choose to notice it. Don't take any chances.
Thank you. pursuit of finding party spots in high school. We are all in pursuit of a place in the world, whether it be the workforce, college, or just simply figuring out who you are. There is a lot of pressure on you to have everything figured out, but I implore you, everything will work out and you will be okay. Life is not a straightforward path to success. You must embrace and nurture the twists and turns that accompany our journey. You must be determined to circle around sometimes. You must be persistent in taking different routes. But most of all, you must be confident that there is a place for us. From our very first day as Opera Christian to now bidding farewell to our dear friends as young adults, these nostalgic memories we've shared will remain within us forever. I know goodbyes are never easy, especially when we've all seen each other grow up these last 4 years and even more. But of course, this is only a speed bump, and there is so much more that lies ahead. Let us slow down and bask in this astounding moment when that appears. And as we conclude our quest of finding our meeting spots, I hope that in our pursuit, we found ourselves as well. Let us cherish everything that has led us up to this point and drive to our bright futures with the love and unconditional support of our parents, friends, and loved ones. Lastly, I just want to say, I love you. I am so, so proud of you. Congratulations, class of 2023.
You could open up your news app and see all the horrible things going on. But you could also walk out. crisis befalling is greater than it is. No matter how precarious the situation may seem, we all see only the dark side and see that the sun is still on the side. All of us look like many battles in our lives. Maybe you were a loved one goes to the doctor and is not a life-changing illness that will define your day-to-day life for the next few months, how many years. Maybe you, like my grandma David, decide to let your little brother drive a tractor and he ends up driving into the fence and you have to spend the rest of the day to see him. Or maybe you just had a long, tough day at work and all you want to do is go home, but you realize that you're out of food to make dinner, so you go to the grocery store and you're half an hour with fluorescent lights instead of eating and long lines before you're able to just go home and relax all day. During these times, you will worry about the future. At least you will if you have enough time left over from modern and present. During these times, though, it will be even more important that you realize what there is to go for. It will be more important than ever that you appreciate your friends and family and that you count all the things that made life suck a little less that day. Focus on making your favorite meal or cheating on your diet and having an ice cream. Focus on taking a mental unlock and the beautiful sunshine and ice creams. Focus on taking that dear girl you met while rat-hunting to the Orpheum Theater in your dorm for the first time. Unfortunately, when your bad times are ending, someone else's are just beginning. Because of that, we have to productively use our energy in our good times to end our neighbor's bad times. Maybe you do that professionally through a job that works with people and helps them solve their problems. Maybe you do that by buying coffee for the person behind you and complimenting the person's classes. Or maybe you do that by carrying bales of ashes for the janitor at the Williamstown School, 2.5 miles from the apartment. Let's be honest, if your only goal is to survive, you're probably not setting yourself up for success. Therefore, you must also strive to make the world better than you found it and focus on bringing good into the world with everything you do. So today, as you graduate from high school and move on to the next chapter, let's all work to make the world better, not only for those who are stuck on it with us, but for those who will be meeting on our tombstones one day. Do it for those who will be reading our handwritten books of life advice one day. Thank you.
Thank you. Joseph Clement, Joseph Conway, etc.
idea